Hi guys, thanks for tuning in to another video on ForgottenWeapons.com. I'm Ian McCollum, and today we are going to do a brief evaluation of some Ethiopian 30-06 caliber ammunition. For you metric folks, that would be 7.62 by 63 millimeter. And we have this in two different types of packaging, although it's the same ammunition. We have one ammo can here that is loose packed in 15-round boxes. We have one ammo can that here that is packaged in M1 Garand clips, and that gives us a hint as to why Ethiopia was manufacturing 30-06 caliber ammunition. They had a bunch of U.S. surplus firearms to use it in. M1 Garand rifles, 1918 or 1918A2 BAR automatic rifles, and then they had also Browning machine guns, both 1917 and 1919 air-cooled and water-cooled machine guns that all used 30-06 caliber ammunition. So these were manufactured at what began as the Emperor Haile Selassie, I think, something pronounced vaguely like that, the first ammunition factory, which was set up in the late 1940s in Addis Ababa, with technological assistance from the Czech government. However, these were manufactured, these particular cartridges, these batches, in 1977, and Selassie was removed from power in 1974. So when these were manufactured, the name of the factory had actually changed, and you'll see that the head stamp is different for that reason. So we're going to go ahead and run 15 rounds of this through a rifle. It is specifically a U.S. model of 1917 Enfield rifle. Has a 26-inch barrel, and it is a nice, strong action, so it should be perfectly capable of handling whatever these cartridges might throw its way. So let's go ahead and take a look at that.
This will hold six, but we're going to do batches of five just to keep track. Alrighty, here we go. 29.55. 30.15. And I popped the shade off of my crown. All right. Pick that back up. 30.28. 29.93. 29.92. Go ahead and load five more. 29.76. 3009. And I popped the shade off again. We are doing this at 3 meters distance, by the way. 3017. 3020. 29.95. Last set of five rounds. 29.41. 3001. Pop the shade one more. 3031. 29.94. Last round. 3007.
So, our overall assessment, with 15 rounds as our group for firing, we got an average velocity of 2,998 feet per second. So we can round that to 3,000, basically. Spread, extreme spread, was 90 feet per second, which gives us a standard deviation of 25.36 feet per second. That's not the worst we've ever seen, but it's far from the best. So that's less than you would expect for good quality modern factory ammunition. However, there was nothing else with this ammunition that gave problems. No hang fires, no double strikes required. Nothing to give potential issues. As for corrosivity, Century, when they brought this ammunition in, listed it as corrosive. I have seen other retailers listing it as non-corrosive. I would assume this to be corrosive and clean it as such, but I did not actually test that specifically. It is, however, brass cased and boxer primed, and so it is potentially reloadable. If we look at a couple of these cartridges up close, you'll see some good annealing coloration on the necks. There's no corrosion that I found on any of these cartridges. They appear to all be well packed. If we take a look at the head stamps here, you can see we have a primer sealant. These are dated 77, that's 1977, and then they have a three-character abbreviation at the top of the head stamp. That is in Amharic, which is the Ethiopian written alphabet. And each one of those characters actually translates into both a consonant and vowel sound. If you were to translate that into English, it would be M-E-D, which I believe is an abbreviation for Defense Industry Organization, which was, I believe, the name of the factory after Emperor Selassie was overthrown in 1974. The bullets are an American M2 style of flat base, hollow base, flat base, pointed bullet, a little crimping cannelure there. The average weight of the sample of 10 that I took was 150.7 grains. Extreme spread was 1.6 grains with a standard deviation of 0.52 grains. So a pretty well-made bullet, a pretty consistent bullet. Ignore the scoring that you can kind of see there on the sides. That's because I couldn't find my kinetic bullet puller and used a pair of pliers to pull these samples. Packaging for this is 15 rounds in a plain, completely unmarked cardboard box. We do have a nice little cloth pull tab there. Open that up. There's your 15 rounds, 1977 head stamps there. And you get, of course, 15 in the box. There are 300 in the ammo can, so you get 20 of these boxes. In this ammo can, I have already pulled a couple out for shooting, but that's how the stuff's packaged. We do have some markings on the outside of the ammo can, again in Amharic, as you would expect in Ethiopia. This is 300 cartridges, caliber 30, or 30 caliber, 15 cartridges per packet, or box, on this line. And then we have this line, which is, we're going to see repeated. That translates to, this box will be reused, so return it to the ground forces armory. Don't just throw the thing away in the desert when you're done with your training exercise. We do also have some markings in English on the other side. Not sure if that was originally Ethiopian or if those have been overstamped just for purpose of the American importation, but they say the same things. Note, we have a 1978 manufacturing date on this ammo can, as well as 1970 and lot number 30. Exactly why we have the disparity between the dates, 70 versus 78 versus 1977 on the head stamps, I do not know. We do also have a can of this packaged on M1 Garand clips. These are, it's a little hard to see there, but this is an SF marked clip. That is almost certainly not Ethiopian. That is from another country supplier, maybe the US, maybe someone else. I don't know all of my M1 Garand identification codes, but again, the ammunition looks pretty good. It is packaged in a typical M1 Garand type bandolier. You have 6 pockets. I've pulled this one out of that pocket. 8 rounds per. That gives you 48 rounds per bandolier. The bandolier is stamped with basically the same thing that we just saw on the ammo can. Says this carrying belt will be reused, so return it to the ground forces armory. Carrying belt, of course, they mean bandolier. The can itself doesn't have any particular organization inside, just 4 bandoliers kind of stuffed in there. And on the outside, the markings you would expect. It's basically the same thing, except it says 192 rifle cartridges, caliber 30, and packaged. Each clip contains 8 cartridges in carrying belts. And then once again, return the ammo can to the ground forces armory. And as with the previous can, we have basically the same markings in English on the reverse side, along with, again, a 1970 and a 1978 dates, lot number 31, where the previous can was from lot number 30. And the ammunition in this can is also, once again, dated 77. So we have a disparity in dates for some particular reason. I do want to point out that while this would appear to be intended to be basically American M2 ball, or to follow that pattern, with a flat base 150 grain bullet, it is higher velocity than one would expect from M2 ball. The US standard is 1740 feet per second at, I should point out, 78 feet from the muzzle. I was doing my velocity measuring at approximately 10 feet from the muzzle. However, still, the difference between 3,000 feet per second and 2740 or 2760 is way more significant than you will get just from an additional 68 feet of travel. So I would, if I were using this ammunition, I would consider it to be slightly hot and take that into account when choosing what firearms to run it in. A proper bolt action rifle, something with a Mauser action like the 1917 Enfield I'm using, will have absolutely no trouble with this ammunition. But in theory, if you have a relatively old or fragile rifle, talk to a gunsmith before perhaps considering using this ammunition. I did not try this in an M1 Garand. I have not measured slide velocity, bolt velocity in an M1 Garand using this ammunition, and so I cannot comment on that beyond being able to tell you that it does, in fact, in my sample of 15, chronograph out to 3,000 feet per second from a 26-inch barrel at 10 feet from the muzzle. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this brief look at Ethiopian 30-06 ammunition. This was originally imported by Century. It has been distributed out to a number of retailers, and I think there are a few places that still have it in stock, but a bunch of them have sold out. It appears that they didn't import all that much of it when it did come in. So Ethiopian ammo historically has been quite rare to find in the United States. This is a neat batch of it to be able to take a look at. I am enjoying doing these assessments. I think we're going to make this an occasional repeating series on the channel. So if you're interested in, certainly if you're interested in surplus ammunition for shooting, I think this will be a valuable source of information. And if you're not, it still gives us some interesting insight into what countries were making, what kind of quality was involved, what sort of, well, getting to see what actual ammunition was being produced at different times and places through history. Thanks for watching.